In the previous movie, we created a dual IK knee blending solution to switch between a pull vector knee and a no-flip knee. In this movie, we'll add the ability to snap the knee directly to its control. Start by opening the file Character Rigging Part 16 Start, or by using your own file from the previous lesson. As we described in previous movies, IK's greatest advantage is its ability to plant a body part in place so that the animator can move the body around it. Right now, we can't do that as precisely with the knee as we'd like, since the control is for aiming the knee rather than actually placing it. This functionality would be useful in scenarios when the character is doing knee push-ups or dangling upside down from a monkey bar. Basically, any situation where you'd want the legs to stay locked independently of the upper body's motion. First, make sure you've set the knee to full manual mode. Also, unhide the pull vector joint chain again. In order to snap the leg to the knee, we're actually going to stretch the thigh and shin until it reaches the left knee control. To that effect, the first thing we need to do is measure the distance from the start and end of these joints to the left knee control. Using the Create Measure Tools Distance tool, create a distance node by point snapping from the thigh joint to the left knee control. You can make this easier by temporarily making the left knee PV loc visible again, so you have a point to snap to. Rename the nodes left thigh to knee dist start lock, left thigh to knee dist end lock, and left thigh to knee distance, respectively. Now create another set of distance nodes from the left knee control to the foot joint and rename them similarly. We'll want to parent the appropriate locators to the knee control and foot control. Make sure to test that the distance nodes are measured correctly even when you move the controls around. Based on experience, you can predict that we'll use these distance measurements to scale the joints by translating their respective child joints. Unfortunately, there is something blocking us from doing this. Remember that we are already scaling these joints to perform the overall squash and stretch for the entire leg rig. Therefore, we're going to need to make a choice, similar to the way we chose between IK or FK, or auto or manual knees. The length of the leg will be determined either by the overall leg length or by the individual distances of the thigh and foot to the knee. Turn on the shapes display in the outliner. Then select the pole vector thigh, shin, and foot joints, as well as the two shape nodes for the distance nodes you just created. Open the node editor and display their connections. As you can see here, we're currently driving the length of the thigh with an animation curve connected to the translation of the shin. This curve refers to the driven keys we set to stretch the leg as a whole. Therefore, we want to choose to stretch the left thigh either according to this driven key when stretching the entire leg, or according to its distance to the left knee control when snapping to the knee. As usual, we'll use a Blend Colors node to make this choice. Rename this blend node Left Thigh PV Stretch Choice. Feed the distance value of the left thigh to knee distance shape node into the color 1R attribute. Then feed the output of the shin's animation curve into the color 2R attribute. Now delete the incoming connection of the left shin PV IK joint. Instead, we'll feed the output R of our new stretch choice node to the translate X attribute of the left shin PV IK joint, thereby determining its length. It's hard to test this part without hooking up the shin length this way as well, so let's go ahead and do that before we test. Create another blend colors node called left shin PV stretch choice. Feed the left foot to knee is distance output and the foot's animation curve into the color 1R and color 2R inputs respectively. Delete the incoming connection to the left foot PVIK joint, then connect the output R attribute of our stretch choice node to its translate X attribute. Now if you turn both blender attributes to 1, the shin joint section of the geometry snaps to the left knee control. Even if you move the knee, the leg stretches to meet it. All that's left to do is to create a custom attribute on our left knee control to activate and deactivate the knee snapping. Name it knee snap and set its minimum value to 0 and maximum value to 1. Then middle drag the left knee control into the node editor and use the knee snap attribute to drive both blend nodes' blender attributes. This gives us a quick way to toggle the knee snapping on and off. Now you can hide all the locators, distance nodes, and the pole vector leg. That finishes up all our leg functionality. In the next movie, we'll do a bit of cleanup and make sure our leg rig abides by our rigging checklist.